Now we bring trade planning with options. Katie, our options expert and an expert in cycle analysis, combines all of that, our charts with option trading. And she's going to show you short-term bullish options trade in SPX. In the show, we have been warning about that there was a short-term decline coming and that the market then would again attest the upside into the area of mid-August. And this is an options trade that fits into that analysis. And she's going to show that to you. And then I'm going to give you some details later on in the show about how we come to this analysis, which I think you're going to put that all together and love it. All right, so let's take a look here. Katie, show them this great stuff.
Hi, this is Katie Anagnostos, and this is a trade planning with options video on August 3rd, 2023. Today, we're going to look at a trade idea in one of the indexes. First, our legal disclaimer, the options trades that I demo and follow up on are trade ideas. When I talk about closing, adjusting, or managing them, I'm simply educating around management techniques, best practices, theories around risk management and profit taking, and highlighting aspects of options trading that we encounter as we follow these trade ideas. This disclaimer is specifically related to options trading. For full legal information, please go to the AskSlim website or email matt@askslim.com. Let's get started. Today, we're going to look at a short premium trade idea in SPX. That's the S&P 500 cash index. So this is the weekly chart. Some important things to note would be the positive momentum with a green reversal scalp. The projections showing the possibility of running up into these fib extension levels off of the daily chart that I will show you in a few minutes, and also the weekly cycle timing window coming up. This ideal window runs from September 4th to October 13th. Switching over to the daily chart, you'll notice that we are inside that daily cycle timing window right now. It is marked out with these blue vertical dashed lines. Now, I want to show you what this looks like over on the cycle low timing tracker. So let's switch over to that very quickly. This is today's cycle low timing tracker, and you will find SPX as well as NDX up here, right here in the cycle timing box period of risk for the daily time frame. Now, this first column is for the weekly time frame. The second column in each of these boxes is for the daily time frame. So when we begin to get enough positive price action to trigger the bottom pending algorithm, you will also then find SPX in this box, and then subsequently the bottom confirmed box as it moves through these phases. But that has not happened yet. So back over on the daily chart, that daily cycle timing window runs through August 8th. Now our reversal scout has turned negative. The slim ribbon, which colors our candles red, green, or gray, depending on momentum conditions, that is still positive. And this morning we got down into that upper support zone, getting a nice bounce now around midday. So another thing to notice here is that this subsequent daily cycle, this next large dominant cycle, that ends around October 7th, plus and minus several days. So that fits within the weekly cycle timing window when we would expect to get our intermediate low. So although we are expecting a bounce out of this daily cycle timing window, we have to keep in mind that this cycle over here has a likelihood of showing weakness and possible failure as we go into that intermediate low. Another thing we can use is the VIX daily chart. Here's the VIX daily chart. This cycle work here shows that the VIX cycle timing window begins between August 9th and August 18th. So if VIX is due to bottom in that time frame, then the index may peak in that time frame. So for our options trade idea, we're going to do a shorter term trade and use the August 18th monthly expiration with 15 days to go. Back over on the SPX daily chart, the bottom of our support zone here is at about 44.35 with a 78.6% fib at 43.88. Over here on Tasty Trade, I have SPX loaded in here. The IV rank is 12.7. It had come up as the market sold off a little bit this week, now going back down a bit. Let's open up this August 18th expiration cycle. We can use that AM expiration, doesn't really matter because we would be out of this trade one way or the other before then. We're going to do a simple short put spread. Let's sell the 44.35 put, which was at the bottom of that support zone. Then you can make your spread as wide as you want. I'm going to do a $10 wide, so I'll buy the 44.25. Now this gives us a credit of $1.70. Our profit target is about 50% of max profit, so we're looking to take about $85, $90 out of each spread that we trade. Max profit, $170. Max loss, $830. That is also the capital requirement that you need to place this trade. And now let's go and take a look quickly at the risk graph. Here it is. We want SPX to stay above our short strike. We'd like it to move up for time to pass, and a volatility contraction would also be beneficial. Well, Tasty Trade is our preferred options trading platform. Please go over to the askSlim homepage, hover over the Marketing Partners tab, and click on Tasty Trade. That will take you to a page where you can open a Tasty Trade account through our link. Doing that helps you with some special bonuses, and it also helps us, so please consider checking that out. That's our trade planning with options video for today. As always, please feel free to reach out on Discord or via email to katie@askslim.com if you have any questions or feedback.